Yo, 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 CPA Strength, strongest CPA in Florida, back at it again, accounting for beginners number 21. Number 21. We're gonna do a T account example today, example of a T account. I was gonna do a video on trial balance, but to have kind of the, because I've been getting questions on trial balance. To do the trial balance, you need example of T account, and I wanted to do it in different videos. As one of you guys suggested before, you know, I should break down my videos into smaller chunks of information, which I totally agree. So this one's example of T account, number 21, accounting for beginners number 21. T accounts is accounting for beginners number 17. I'll put a link for the T account, accounting for beginners T account. So you might want to watch that before you watch this one. These are journal entries. And these journal entries come from accounting for beginners number 4. So if you want to know how I got these journal entries, how I came about to their a debit or a credit, or if they're an asset or a liability, you might want to watch number 4. Also, if this is the first video you're watching of me, hello. I'm a fucking weirdo, so. Also, if this is the first one, this is kind of my thing here. This DCA blur, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Kind of my thing. I have a lot of videos on it. You might want to watch my accounting series. These are journal entries from Accounting for Beginners number 4. And really the next step would be to make a T account. It makes it easier. In my earlier days of accounting and my dumbness, I got the balances of these accounts by just adding and subtracting. I got so many questions. So how did you come up with that? Because I didn't really answer it. I didn't really go step by step by step. I kind of just assumed that you would know that, and we don't want to do that. We don't want to assume anything. Ooh, look at my shirt. My favorite shirt. If my POS, I hang drywall, jelly roll.
I got out of jail 6 years ago with a dream to do this shit, and I'm gonna tour with goddamn Cypress fucking here.
So these are journal entries that we've already done. We've already determined that these are debits and these are credits. And the debits and credits always, always, always equal. Okay, now we're up to speed. Now you have, we just have 5 journal entries. I don't know, in your classroom exercises, you might have 20, 25, or 30. That's why the T accounts are important. Every journal entry, every account that we have, like we have a cash account, a loan account, a truck account, a rent account, a service income account, and a draw account. Now, you can have whatever accounts on your chart of accounts. That's number 20. I just did an accounting for beginners number 20, which is chart of accounts. Oh, yeah, I was just about to say that I'm not a good teacher, but thanks to you guys have been on my ass for saying that I should ease up on myself, and I'm a decent teacher. So, I am my worst critic. I have so many issues that we don't even want to start with that, but thank you very much for giving me props or whatever. And I am a teacher now, so. When you write a journal entry down, you're gonna create an account. It's kind of a simultaneous thing, whatever. I'm just going from, like when I do it for QuickBooks and stuff in my business, to make a journal entry, you have to have an account and a chart of accounts. The QuickBooks kind of does the T-account examples. The T-account is just to get a balance for each account, basically. That's what I would think. And you have to know debits and credits. So we've already established that before. So let's take the journal entries and transfer them over to the T-accounts. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take journal entries to T-accounts. We have 5 journal entries, let's go step by step and do it. Debit on the left, credit on the right, and they always, always equal. Always, 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 always. Debit, cash for 10,000. So we go in the cash account, debit for 10,000. Yes, we have that. For the credit, for our first journal entry, we have loan for 10,000. We go to our loan account, and we have a credit for 10,000. So look, so we've done the first one. Second journal entry. Debit truck for 5,000. Truck, this is the truck account and chart of accounts. Debit for 5,000. The credit for that, cash 5,000. So we go to our cash of 5 credit, cash for 5,000. So we've done the second one. Third journal entry, debit rent for 500. We go to the rent T account, debit 500, cash 500, credit cash for 500. We go to our cash account, we credit for 500. We've T accounted up to three journal entries. Fourth journal entry, cash debit 800, cash account debit 800. What's the credit for that? Service income, 800 credit. We'll go to the service income account. Credited for 800, good. We've done the fourth journal entry. Now we're gonna go for our fifth journal entry. Debit draw 100. We go to the draw T account, debit of $100. Now we go to the a credit cash of 100. Credit cash of 100. The fifth journal entry is done. You notice that we've just taken whatever's a debit over here, whatever's a debit, we put on the debit side. Whatever's a credit in our journal entry goes on the credit side. Ooh, I'm gonna chop some of this out, but hey, your boy likes to talk. Anyways, so let me get out of the way. So here's our T accounts. This is over here now. So the ones with only one number in it, that's gonna be the balance. So loan, you have a $10,000 credit balance. Truck, $5,000 debit balance. Rent, $500 debit balance. Service income, $800 credit balance. Draw, $100 debit balance. Cash is the one that we're gonna work with. And in my infinite wisdom before, I thought, oh, you don't need T accounts, they're stupid. But then I got so many questions on, hey, how did you get cash to equal $5,200? I think in my accounting for beginners number 5, I skipped T account, I skipped trial balance, and I just went to the income statement. I skipped so much, sorry. And I got so many questions on how did you get the cash to be $5,200? Because I just went, oh, 10,000 minus 5,000 minus 500 plus 800 minus 100. But that confused everybody. I'm going to show you how I got that. We transferred for cash. This is kind of the hard one. We transferred each debit or credit in our journal entries, put it in the cash account. There's a bunch of different ways that you can get the $5,200. You can add these up, 10,800 minus 5,600 is 5,200. I'd probably just take a calculator, start with, so you kind of know, like 10,000, you got 10,000 in your account, minus 5,000, so that's a $5,000 balance. Add 800, 5,800 minus 500, 5,300 minus 100, 5,200. So these are the account balances, and I already know what my next video is going to be. Look for it. It's going to be just kind of an extension of this one. It's going to be about trial balances. I appreciate everybody watching these. I get so much enjoyment and satisfaction out of making these. I never thought I would enjoy this so much, but I really, really do. I know that's your boy, but he kind of corny. I'm gonna leave your dog stretched out like Slinky from Toy Story.